Okay, today we are going to see about the number system. Last class we have seen just some small introduction about the history of digital electronics. Now we'll be seeing the number system. So when you say number system, already you are familiar with the decimal number system, which starts from 0 to 9. So when you write 10, again you'll be writing 1 and 0. Then 11, 1, 1. Then 20 means 2, 0. Again, it starts from 0 to 9 only. So 0 to 9 digits you will be using continuously or interchangingly, and you will write your decimal number system. And this is what you are familiar so far. Now we are going to see some more number systems. They are called binary, hexadecimal, and octal number system, which all these things are used in our computer. So before that, we will see there are basically two electrical signals, namely analog and digital. The analog signals are continuous. That's what we have seen in the last class, where I have drawn a diagram showing that just like a sine wave. It is a continuous signals, and they are continuous in nature, and whereas digital signals are discrete. That is either a one or a complete low. So that is why it is called discrete. Okay, the electronic device that works with continuous signal is called analog device. And the electronic device that works with discrete signals, they are called digital device. For analog, you can say clock, which we are having in our home, we have analog clocks. Whereas a digital clock that you know, which displays the time. And it works with discrete signals. So computers or digital device, which works with two levels of signals called 1 and 0, or you can say it is a high and low. Computer is used to solve mainly the numerical system. So it is not convenient to work with symbolic representation, which is present in analog. That is why we go for numeric representation. We'll see what are all the number system which we are going to study in our class. This is nothing but decimal number system, binary, octal, and hexa. Decimal already you know, but what we are going to study here is how to convert a decimal number to binary, decimal to octal, and decimal to hexa. In same way, binary to decimal, binary to octal, binary to hexa, and so on. That's what we are going to see in two or three classes. So first we'll see, this is a binary means how you will write. It has a base. So when you say decimal, it has a base 10. Because why we call it as a base 10? It has 10 numbers. So for example, 0 to 9, when you say, there are totally 10 numbers. That we call it as a base. Okay. So if you take binary, we have two numbers. Either a 0 or a 1. So there are two numbers. That we call it as a base. So a binary is having base 2 and octal. Octal, the name itself, you know, 8. Okay, so from 0 to 7. Here the representation is how many numbers that particular system will be able to represent. Okay, and that itself we are taking it as a base. So 0 to 7, totally 8 numbers. So we call it as a base 8. Then hexadecimal, 0 to 15. So when you include 0 also, it is totally 16. So that's what the base is 16. So this is how we call it as a base of a number system. Now, what are all the element number of digits present in this base? For binary, it is 0 to 1. Then octal, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. For decimal, you know, 0 to 9. And hexadecimal, how you will represent? From 0 to 9. And then after that, you say it as A, B, C, D, E, and F. Okay, so 9, after 9 it is 10, but 10 you don't represent as 10. Instead, here you will call it as A, B, C, D, E, F. Then after this, so for example, here 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 will be again 0. So, how you will represent a 16? You won't represent as a 0. That is, after this it becomes 10. Are you able to follow? After F, because see how you will be calling here 0 to 9, after that how you will represent 10, 10, then 11, 12, 11, 12, 13, like that. So here after F, Again, you start with 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, and so on till 1, 9. Then after 1, 9, it is 1A, 1B, 1C, and so on. Then after here, F, again, it starts from things that is 2, 0, 2, 1, 2, 2, which means how you represent here 0 to 9. Likewise, here 0 to F. The same thing, same methodology, but after F, 16, that 11, 17, sorry, here 0 to 15, 16, you will represent it as 1 and 0. Okay, so 1, 0, 1, 1, up to 1, 9, then 1, A, and so on. So like that, it will come. Are you able to follow, girls?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes. Any doubt?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
This hexadecimal representation, are you able to follow? Okay.
Yes,
the same way for octal also, up to 7. Then after that, it will come as 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. And then again, it starts from 20 and so on. In any way, it will have only up to 7 digits, 7 numbers only. 0 to 7 only will be in that particular digit representation. Then, here. So, we call the, respective position, we call them as a positional value. So, for example, 7, 3, 7. This is a decimal number representation. 7, 3, 7. So, how you will say unit? Tens, hundreds, thousands, like that you will be saying. That we call it as a positional value. So how you will represent that unit? 7 here, this 7 into 10 power 0. Anything power 0 is 1. Okay, so 7 into 10 power 0 means it is 7 into 1 only. Then this you will be representing 3 into 10 power 1, which is nothing but 30. That is what here. It is 30. It represents the positional value. Then 10 power 2 is 100. So 7 into 10 power 2, this 7 into 100 is 700. So 700, 30 plus 7. That is, so this you can represent like this. Same way, if you take 8, 9, 6, 5. Here 5 into 10 power 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Okay. So here also it's like that. Now, this is what here I have represented, but with the fractional number. So you can say this for 4 into 10 power 0, 3 into 10 power 1, 2 into 10 power 2, 1 into 10 power 3. So that's what here has been written. That is 1200. Here for this, it is 30. See here, it is 4. Then, how the fractional number, how you will calculate the fractional number, equal and positional value from here, starting from here you will do, not from here. Here we start from decimal place, we are considering. But here, decimal place, right hand side, we take. So, we will count. So, 5 into 0.1. Why it is 0.1? Because this will be considered as 1 by 10. Okay, so இங்க எப்படி நம்ம சொல்றோம் 10 பவர் 1ங்கற மாதிரி இது வந்து division. So 5 into 1 by 10. அப்போ இந்த 10 பவர் 0 வராது. 5 into, I'll tell you, 1 minute. One minute, I'll explain this. See here. this you will know how to write. That is 4 into 10 power 0. Now we'll come to this 5. So how you will be writing 5 into 1 by 10. Like this you will write. Then plus, this is plus. Okay. Oh, next is 6. So 6 into 1 by 10 power 2, which is nothing but 100. Okay, then plus 7 into 1 by 1000. Is 10 power 3, 10 power 1, 10 power 2, 10 power 3. Here 10 power 0 will not come. Okay, so if you write this, how you will be representing? It is 5 into 0.1. This is what we have written as 0.1. This 10 you can represent as 0.1. Same way 6, this 100. How you will be representing? 0.001. Like this you can represent. Yes or no? So that is what here we have written. Sorry, 0.01. Okay, the same way for 1000, you'll be representing 0.001. Okay, girls, are you able to follow?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
This representation, yeah. Are you able to follow? Okay. So now I proceed. So this is how you write, and then you add all these things. See how you are adding all these things like this. See here. So we are adding this. So if you see this value, 5 into 10 point, that is 5 into 0.1, you get 0.5. Then this, you have 0.06, then this you will be having. So when you add all these things, you will be getting this value. Why I am teaching you this is, this will be useful for you to follow the next number systems. When you are going to write for binary, octal, hexadecimal, you will be following the same methodology. That's why. So next, we'll go to the positional value of all the number systems. So here, weightage of each position is given at 10 power 0. When it comes to decimal system, it is 10 power 0, 10 power 1, 10 power 2, 10 power 3, and so on. So when it comes to decimal floating, that is after point, you will be having 10 power minus 1. That is why 1 by 10, which is nothing but 10 power minus 1, when you are representing flat. So 10 power minus 2, minus 3, and so on. You don't have 10 power minus 0. Okay, here, whereas here it starts from 0, whereas here it is minus 1 only. So same way for binary system also, you can represent as, already we have seen the base is 2, 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Here the same way, 2 power minus 1. How here we are representing as minus 1, here 2 power minus 1, which is nothing but 1 by 2, then 1 by 2 power 2, 1 by 2 power 3, and so on. Then same way for octal system, here floating point, same way, 8 power minus 1. For hexadecimal also, it's similar. The base is different, that's all. Okay, now we'll see the first conversion, decimal to binary. That means, given a decimal number, you have to represent them in terms of ones and zeros only. Okay, so we will see how to do that. So in order to do the decimal to binary, what are the things we have to do? So divide by 2, because it is given in decimal number, which is of base 10. Now to convert it into binary, you have to use the respective number system. Okay, so if you are going to convert a decimal to octal, you have to divide that number by 8. When you are going to convert decimal to hexa, you have to divide it by 16. Same way here, decimal to binary, you have to divide the number by 2. Continuously you have to divide, and the remainder you have to take. So the first remainder is bit 0. LSB, then second remainder is bit 1. Now we'll see the next one, how to do the decimal division. Now you take this Let us consider a number 43. Okay, now you divide it by 2. So when you divide it by 2, what will happen? This is 2 times. So 2, then for 3, it is 1 time because then the remainder is 1. So put a hyphen and keep the remainder here. Same way you divide it again by 2. So it is 1 time. Here there is no, so 0, then the remainder is 1. Again the 2, it is 5 and 0. There is no remainder, so it is 0. 2, here there is a remainder. 2 times, then 1, remainder is 1. 2 and then 1 and then there is no remainder, so 0. So this is the further you cannot divide. With this, it is over. When you reach 1, it is over. Now what you will be doing, you have to write, now you have found the binary, but you should know how to interpret it. So you have to read it from here to upwards, okay, like this. That's why I have given the arrow mark from this side to this, like this only you have to do the reading. So how you will be writing? 1, see here, then 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. So this is the this is the equivalent. 43 equivalent binary number is, this is what. So now I would like to know whether what I have found is correct or not. Yes, you can do the verification. When you convert it back to decimal, you must get 43. We'll see how to get. Since it is 1, now here, from starting here, you substitute it with, how you will be converting a binary number to decimal? By multiplying its base. Okay, so here 1 means 1 into 2 power 0. Then 1, 1 into 2 power 1. This is what we have seen in the last one. Yes or no? When you are doing, how you will be doing? 7 into 10 power 0, 7, 3 into 10, likewise, here, see, we want to find its decimal equivalent. So how you can do? Multiply it by its base. Multiply the binary by its base only. So 2 power 0, 1 into 2 power 0, 1 into 2 power 1, then 0 into 2 power 2, 1 into 2 power 3, 0 into 2 power 4, 1 into 2 power 5. The 0 multiply by 0, it will be 0. Okay. So now you calculate this. 2 power 5 is 32. Yes or no? If you don't know, you do it. What is 2 power 2?
4, ma'am.
2 power 2, 4. 4. 4, sorry. 2 power 5 will not come to the. No. 2 power 5 will not. 32. 32. 32. 32. 32. Yes, now you do. 5 times, 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 2, 8. 8 into 2, 16. 16 into 2, 32. Okay, 32. Clear. So likewise, you have to calculate for all the other works. So here it is 32, then 0, substitute the 0 here, then 2 power 3 is 8, 2 into 2 into 2. So 8, then this is 0, then for this it is 2, 2 power 1 is 2. Okay, 2 power 0 on the 1, 2 power 1 on the 2. I hope all of you are able to follow. Yes or no? Anything power 0 is
yes, 1.
Now, ana inge vandu 2 power 1 ngirathu 2. So 1 into 2 is 2. Then inge vandu 1 kedaikum. 2 power 0 ngirathu 1. So 1 into 1 it is 1. Now you add all these things, you will be getting this 43 again. Are you able to follow, girls? This is how you can verify your answer. Continuous divide panni, then we have written this. Then it is equivalent. Inge irundhu 2 power 0 podakudadu. Inge irundhu dhaan ponnum. Puriyudha? Idhu dhaan first position, second position and so on. So idhukku dhaan nee vandhu 2 power 0. Inge irundhu 2 power 0 pottingna thappaidum. You have to do it from left to right. Now, as another example, let us take 25. 25, when you divide 2, now this is 1, here it is 2 times, 2 times 4, so remaining is 1 and so on. So 2, 6, remaining is 0, 2 divided 3, remainder is 0, again 2, 1, the remainder is 1. Now read it like this. So 1, 1, 0, 0 and 1. When you do the same reverse conversion, so 1 into 2 power 0, it is 0 into 2 power 1, this is 0 into 2 power 2, 1 into 2 power 3, 1 into 2 power 4. Now 16, this is 2 power 4 is 16, 8 plus, here it is 0. Anything multiplied by 0 is 0. So this is also 0 and this is 1. When you add all these things, you will be getting 25. Are you able to follow? This is
how? Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Pena pandringa ellaro in the values irukleya, do the following conversion from decimal to binary. All of you note down this value. Na appo assignment kudupen, you have to do 244, 145, 112. Base vandhi ipdi ezhudikkanum. Appadina idhu vandhu decimal la irukku nu artham. Now you have to convert it into binary. இந்த மூணு ப்ராப்ளமும் நோட் பண்ணிட்டீங்களா எல்லாரும்? இன்னும் ஒரு ரெண்டு மூணு ப்ராப்ளம் கொடுப்பேன், அதெல்லாம் செஞ்சு எனக்கு ஜிசிஆர்ல அப்லோட் பண்ணும். ஐ வில் கிவ் யூ டைம் டு டூ தட். ஓகே, மேபி திஸ் வீக் ஆர் ஆன் மண்டே யூ ஹாவ் டு சப்மிட் யுவர் அசைன்மெண்ட். திஸ் ஆல்சோ வில் பி இன்க்ளூடட் ஃபார் யுவர் இன்டர்னல். ஸோ டேக் டவுன் திஸ் ப்ராப்ளம். யாரும் நோட் பண்ணலன்னா நோட் பண்ணிக்கோங்க. Shall I go to the next one?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, what we are going to see here is, previously we have seen a whole number. Now we are going to see conversion of a decimal to binary with fractions. Okay. So, if in the number, this is a fractional number. 118 whole number. After this we have fraction. This you will be carrying over as usual. இதுக்கு முன்னாடி நான் எப்படி சொல்லி கொடுத்தனோ இது ரெண்டுமே தனித்தனியா தான் பார்க்கணும். So 118 க்கு we will do normal this thing. So when you see 1182, again it is 59, remainder 0 and so on. So when you do all these things, you will be having, this is the answer for 118. Now we concentrate on this fractional number. ஃப்ராக்ஷனல் நம்பர் நான் சொல்லியிருக்கேன், இங்கிருந்து எடுத்துக்கணும். இது எப்படி நீ இங்கிருந்து எடுத்தியோ அதே மாதிரி இது இங்கிருந்து எடுத்துக்கணும். 8 இதுதான் 2 பவர் -1, இது 2 பவர் -2 ஆன் ஸோ ஆன். ஸோ இங்கே பார்த்தீங்கன்னா 0.8125 இன்ட்டு 2. நவ் யூ ஆர் மல்டிப்ளையிங் இட் பை 2. ஓகே, ஸோ வென் யூ மல்டிப்ளை ஹவு இட் வில் டேக் பை ஹவு இட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ். ஸோ இது ரெண்டையும் மல்டிப்ளை பண்ணுறப்போ நமக்கு இந்த ஆன்சர் வருது, 1.6250. ஓகே, ஸோ இதில் நம்ம என்ன பண்ணுறோம், கேரி வந்து தனியாக எடுத்துக்கிற, இதோட ரிமைண்டர் இங்கே எழுதுற, இந்த பாயிண்ட்டுக்கு அப்புறம் வர ரிமைண்டர் அதுதான் ரிமைண்டர். ஸோ தட் யூ ரைட் இட் செப்பரேட்லி அண்ட் தென் யூ ரைட் கேரி. இந்த முன்னாடி இது இதுதான் நம்ம கேரின்னு எடுத்துக்கிறோம். ஓகே, இன்டீஜர் போர்ஷனை கேரின்னு எடுத்துக்கிறோம். ஸோ தட் யூ ரைட் இட் ஹியர். தென் இப்போ இந்த ரிமைண்டர் போர்ஷன் வருது இல்லையா, இந்த போர்ஷன் இதை நான் மறுபடியும் 2 ஆல வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு மல்டிப்ளை, 0.625 இன்டு 2. ஸோ இப்போ பார்த்தோம்னா வென் யூ மல்டிப்ளை திஸ் அகெயின் யூ வில் பி கெட்டிங் 1.25. ஸோ இதை மறுபடியும் நம்ம என்ன பண்ணுறோம், இந்த பாயிண்ட்டுக்கு முன்னாடி இருக்கிறது, டெசிமலுக்கு அப்புறம் இருக்கிறது தனியாக எடுத்துக்கிறோம். தட் இஸ் 0.25 வித் ரெப்ரஸன்டேஷன் ஆஸ் 0.25. இதுக்கு முன்னாடி இஃப் எனி இன்டீஜர் கம்ஸ் தட் வி ரைட் இட் ஹியர். ஓகே, அண்ட் தென் இப்போ நான் இதைத்தான் மல்டிப்ளை பண்ணணும். நான் ஏன் இங்கே தனியாக எழுதுறேன்னா இதை தான் நான் அடுத்த ஸ்டெப்பில் மல்டிப்ளை பண்ணுறோம். ஓகே, ஸோ இங்கே 0.25 வி ஆர் மல்டிப்ளைங் ஹியர் இன்டூ 2. ஸோ நவ் வென் யூ டூ மல்டிப்ளிகேஷன் யூ வில் பி கெட்டிங் 0.50. ஸோ பிஃபோர் த டெசிமல் பாயிண்ட் ஆல்சோ இட் இல் வி ஆர் ஹேவிங் ஒன்லி 0. ஓகே, இங்கெல்லாம் 1 வந்தது, ஏன்னா மல்டிப்ளை பண்ணுறப்போ அந்த வேல்யூ வருது. இங்கே வந்து 0.50. ஸோ இதை அப்படியே எழுது, இந்த பாயிண்ட்டுக்கு அப்புறம் இருக்கிறது வி ஆர் ரைட்டிங் இட் அண்ட் தென் கேரி இஸ் வாட் 0. So that I am writing. Then again we are multiplying this, okay, by 2. So 1.0. So remainder is 0.0 and the carry is 1. We call it as a carry. Okay, then so now how you will be, இது எப்படி நாம் இப்படி ரீட் பண்ணுறோமோ அதே மாதிரி இதை நான் இப்படி ரீட் பண்ணணும். ஓகே, ஃப்ராக்ஷனல் பார்ட்டுக்கு இப்படி எழுதிட்டு தென் வி ஹவ் டு டூ லைக் திஸ். நவ் வென் யூ ரைட் லைக் திஸ் 1101. Why I am stopping it here? Because 0.0 க்கு அப்புறம் நீ எத்தனை மல்டிப்ளை பண்ணாலும் அது ஜீரோவால் மல்டிப்ளை பண்ண எது எவ்வளோ பண்ணாலும் ஜீரோ தான் வரும். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் வேர் வி ஹாவ் டு ஸ்டாப். ஆர் எல்ஸ் If it keeps on going, multiplication is taking place, then you can find up to 4 digits. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 multiplication is enough. Okay, not more than that. So up to 4 precisions is enough for that after the point. So இதோட நீ இங்க இதுக்கு அப்புறம் நீ வேற வேல்யூ வந்தா கூட நீ இதோடவே நிறுத்திக்கலாம் ஒன்றும் ப்ராப்ளம் இல்லை. நவ் ஸோ ஹியர் சி திஸ் ஹவ் இட் இஸ் பீன் ரிட்டன் 1110110 எழுதிட்டு தென் பாயிண்ட் 1101 திஸ் இஸ் வாட் வி ஹவ் ரிட்டன். ஸோ த பைனரி ஈக்குவலண்ட் ஆஃப் திஸ் டெசிமல் இஸ் திஸ். ஆர் யூ ஏபிள் டு ஃபாலோ கேர்ள்ஸ்?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am.
We will see another problem which is given here. 54.6875. So here 54 we are dividing it. I think there is no need for the explanations. When you keep dividing and the remainder, you have to keep it like that and you have to read it like this. So you will be getting this answer. 110110. That is what I have written here. Then 0.6875. Is the லெஃப்ட் ஹேண்ட்ல இருக்கு, ரைட் ஹேண்ட்ல இருக்கிற இந்த டெசிமலுக்கு அப்புறம் வர. ஸோ 0.6875 திஸ் யூ ஆர் மல்டிப்ளைங் இட் பை டூ. இங்கே எல்லாமே டூவா, இங்கே எப்படி டிவைடட் பை டூவோ இதை வந்து மல்டிப்ளை பை டூவா பண்ணுறோம். ஓகே, இதை நம்ம டிவைட் பண்ணக்கூடாது. இதையும் இது மல்டிப்ளிகேஷன், இது டிவிஷன். தென் வென் யூ மல்டிப்ளை இட் பை டூ யூ கெட் திஸ் ஆன்சர். இதில் வந்து இதை வந்து இங்கே எழுதிக்கிறோம், இதில் கேரி, இது ரிமைண்டர், கேரி வந்து 1. ஸோ தட் வி ரைட். So like this, when you do that, 0.37, இங்கே எழுதுறது தான் நம்ம இங்கே மல்டிப்ளை பண்ணுறோம். பண்ணுறப்போ வி கெட் திஸ் அகெயின், யூ ரைட் த ரிமைண்டர் அண்ட் தென் கேரி அண்ட் ஸோ ஆன். இங்கே கேரி கிடையாது, ஜீரோ. ஸோ அதை நம்ம எழுதிக்கிறோம். ஸோ லைக் திஸ் வி செப்பரேட் இட், செப்பரேட் த ரிமைண்டர் அண்ட் த ரிமைண்டர் அண்ட் த கேரி. ஸோ யூ ரீட் இட் டவுன்வர்ட்ஸ் 1011. ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் வாட் த ஆன்சர். எனி டவுட் எனிபடி இஸ் ஹேவிங்? Shall we proceed to the next one?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, girls. Now we will move to the conversion. That is, here what we have done is decimal, given a decimal number, how to convert it into binary. Now we are going to do the reverse. Given a binary number, how to convert it into a decimal. So, already we know the positional values and the rightmost is here. There is one more keyword I am introducing you: least significant bit and most significant bit. What do you mean by least significant and most? The last bit. Okay, when you go like this here, this is said to be least, this is said to be least significant bit, whereas here this will be called as most significant bit. Now, binary to decimal can be converted using this 3 steps. Multiply each bit given the binary bit. So this is the 1 bit. Multiply each and every bit by its equivalent positional value. So here it is 1 means you have to multiply 1 with 2 power 0. For this 1, you have to multiply it with 2 power 1 and so on. So multiply each bit by 2 power n, where n is the weight of that bit. Here n, weight of the bit is 0, weight of this bit is 1 and so on. The weight is the position of the bit starting from 0 on the right. So then finally add the result. Now we'll see. Now as an example, we'll see this 11010. So this is a binary number. You are asked to convert it into its equivalent decimal. So 1 into, if we learn the path, 0. நம்ம பின்னாடி இருந்து போவோம். 0 × 2 power 0, 1 × 2 power 1, 0 × 2 power 2, தென் 1 × 2 power 3, 1 × 2 power 4. ஸோ இன் அசெண்டிங் ஆர்டர். இப்போ இதில் பார்த்தோம்னா 1 × 2 power 4, 16. ஹியர் இட் இஸ் 8. ஹியர் இட் இஸ் 0 மல்டிப்ளை பை 0, எனி திங் 0. தென் ஃபார் திஸ் இட் இஸ் 2 அண்ட் 0. ஃபைனலி வீல் கெட் த 26. இன்னொரு எக்ஸாம்பிள், ஹியர் திஸ் அனதர் எக்ஸாம்பிள், 101011. ஸோ இதை நீ இப்படியும் எழுதலாம், இப்படியும் எழுதலாம், இல்லை இப்படியும் எழுதலாம். தட் இஸ் 1 × 2 power 0, 1 × 2 power 1. ஸோ நான் இப்படி அதோட மல்டிப்ளை பண்ணி அந்த வேல்யூ எழுதி இப்படி ஆட் பண்ணியிருக்கேன். இப்படியும் பண்ணலாம், Okay, so both are same. Now, any doubt in this, girls?
No, ma'am.
Okay, now what you do is you copy this numbers. All of you copy this number, three problems. So what you have to do is the binary number has to be converted into decimal. Note down the problem. One zero one zero one zero. The next is 111010. Then the third one is 110001. Finish?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, very good.
Okay. Now, we are going to see the conversion with fractional number. Okay. So, binary to decimal conversion along with its fraction. So, this is as usual. You'll be multiplying it with its positional value. 1010. See here, this zero. It starts from here. This is for fractional part. So 0 into 2 power 0, 1 into 2 power 1, 0 into 2 power 2, 1 into 2 power 3, plus here 0 into 2 power minus 1, then 1 into 2 power minus 2, 1 into 2 power minus 3. So when you substitute the equivalent value, you'll be getting 8, 0. Then for 2, here it is 0. Then anything multiplied by 0 is 0. Here, 1 by 4. 1 into 1 by 4. Here, 1 into 2 power minus 3 na 8. So 1 by 8. So this is what. Now you have to evaluate this. So here into add panna 10 give a room, point. When you are evaluating, you'll be getting this value. You can do what? 1 by 4, it is 0.25. 1 by 8 is 0.25. Add it. And then here you put that value. Yeah, if you want, you can keep this as a reference. இது வந்து சீக்கிரம் உனக்கு இது எப்பவுமே ஞாபகம் வச்சுட்டீங்கன்னா இது ஆல்மோஸ்ட் 2 பவர் -5 மேல நம்ம போட மாட்டோம் சரியா இஸ் இட் ஸோ இஃப் யூ ரிமெம்பர் திஸ் வேல்யூ யூ கேன் ஃபாஸ்ட்லி யூ கேன் சப்ஸ்டியூட் திஸ் வேல்யூ அண்ட் யூ கேன் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் தென் ஹியர் this is another, it's a very small example which is having the numerical, the binary value itself is only this. So inge pathinga 0 onum kedaiyadhu. So we go straight to the fractional number. So idu pathana inge irundhu eduthamna this into 1 into 2 power minus 1, 0 into 2 power minus 2, -3 -4. So adha inge inge irukra value dhaan inge substitute pannirka. You can understand anything by 1 into ngirappo nam idhe dhaan pannuvom. So when you add this, you get 0.6875. That is the equivalent of this number. Okay. So now this is another example. You can just check it. இது வந்து 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Plus, இங்க என்ன வரும்? 2 power minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. That's what we have written. Then here it is 8. Then it is 4. Here it is 0. And here it is 1. Then here it is 0, here it is 1 by 4, 1 by 8, and 1 by 16. You can substitute these values, you can add all these things, and you will be getting the binary, the decimal equivalent of this number as 13.4375. I have given some more example. If you want, I will share this PowerPoint. Even I will put all these PowerPoint in our Google Classroom, as well as the video I am recording, everything I will be putting it in the Google Classroom. So that even if whenever you have doubt, you can just play it again and see the class. Watch the class. Is it clear, girls?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, few more example is there. Here it is again, all these are binary. Here the conversion is given. For this, it is 2 power minus 1, 2 2 power minus 2. So 2 power minus 1 is 0.5. Here 0.5. This is the answer. You add these two, 0.75. Same way here, 1 into 2 power, 1 into 2 power 0, 2 power 1. Here it is minus 3, sorry, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So, இது ரெண்டும் கிடையாது. அதனால இங்க டைரக்டா நான் அதை போட்டேன். ஜீரோவால இருக்கறனால ஹியர் நாங்க போடல.
மேம் ஆ
சொல்லுமா.
Is it necessary to write notes for this lesson, ma'am?
Yes, because we will ask questions from this.
Okay, ma'am.
How the mathematics in maths you will be writing the, you will be solving the problems, yes or no?
Yes,
ma'am. It is a maths paper. Similarly, we will ask questions.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, I will give you the problems like this. Convert the following number to this system from binary to decimal, from binary to hexa. I will ask questions like that. So you must be able to do that. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
It is not that if you want to take notes, you can take. Or else you just follow the classroom teaching. And then whatever I am posting it in the Google Classroom, other than that, you will be having your book. I have even posted ebook, 2 PDFs, which you are going to follow for your classroom teaching. Okay, I have posted those 2 textbook also in the GCR. I hope all of you should have observed that. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
You can find the materials there. You can find the book materials for reading for this logic there also you can find. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, you kuduthingala ma'am problems ipa?
Ama.
Adu thani note la ezhudruma ma'am? Illa rough note la podu?
Yes. Yes, yes. In separate, you keep a separate note for digital.
Okay, ma'am. Thanks, ma'am.
In that, you have to write down all the assignments. So once I say you have to upload the information in the GCR, you should scan it and then you have to upload along with your name. If the register number or the roll number is given, that also must be entered in your assignment. Is it clear?
Yes,
okay. Yes, I think it's almost okay, time. You are having the next class now, yes or no?
Yes, ma'am. Now the
one minute, I stop recording.